Grace, mercy, and peace to you from God our Father, from our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Amen. The text of our message this morning comes from our gospel lesson, these words of our Savior. Jesus came and said to them, "All authority in heaven and earth has been given to me. Therefore, as you go, make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, teaching them to observe everything I have commanded you, and behold, I am with you always, to the very end of the age." These are the words of our Lord that we will meditate upon this morning as we contemplate this Trinity Sunday. My brothers and sisters in Christ, ever since not long after 9/11, it has become very politically correct within our country to say that Christians, Muslims, and Jews all have the same God. On the other hand, you will also hear some people say that it doesn't matter what you believe as long as you believe something. In a poll that was taken of Missouri Synod Lutherans not too long ago, a scary high percentage of them responded that you can get to heaven without believing in Jesus. Now, my friends, I'm not going to sugarcoat any of this. Everything I just told you there is a lie. So on this Trinity Sunday, we're going to look at the truth. We're going to look at who God is and the truth of the Trinity. God is the Trinity. He is Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Not three gods, but one God in three persons. And now I know some of you out there are saying, "Boy, now it's time for Pastor to explain this to me, because I've never been able to kind of wrap my head around this concept." After all, Pastor went to seminary. Pastor's been studying the Bible for years now. He should be able to explain this to me. Well, sorry to disappoint you, but I can't explain it to you. Because it can't be explained. You see, think about it. We explain things to other people who don't understand things by relating them to things that they might already know. You know, like, what does rattlesnake taste like? Well, it tastes like chicken. You ever notice everything tastes like chicken? But you can't describe God that way because there is nothing similar to God. God is the great I Am because there is no other. So it is by Holy Spirit-given faith that we know God, as God chooses to reveal himself to us in the Holy Bible. And so we might not understand it, but we believe it and we trust that God is Father, God is Son, God is Holy Spirit, one God, in three persons. So since I can't explain God to you, instead this morning I'm going to do something I can. I'm going to dispel for you the lies about God that are out there that Satan is throwing out to confuse. First of all, despite what people say, the God of the Muslim, the God of the Jew is not the true God of Christianity. For both of those religions deny Jesus as God and Lord and Savior. To the Muslim, he is a prophet, but a prophet less than Muhammad, and he definitely is not God. But what does Jesus say about himself? Jesus says, "Before Abraham was, I am." Jesus says, "I and the Father are one." Jesus says, "He who has seen me has seen the Father." By his own words, Jesus is undeniably God, and as the Bible tells us later, in him the whole fullness of the deity dwells in bodily form. It is only God who can take all of our sins into himself. It is only God who can then die for those sins in our place. It is only God who can then take up his own life again to show that he is saved. And sadly, the character of God that the Jews have fabricated among themselves today abandons their one true God, because the Bible says that they have rejected the Son and they resist the Holy Spirit. The martyr Stephen, proclaiming Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior to his fellow Jews was being stoned to death for his faithful confession. And as he is being stoned, he says, "You stiff-necked people, uncircumcised in heart and ears, you always resist the Holy Spirit as your fathers did, so do you." My friends, here's the truth. Today, right now, in this world, there are over 4 billion, billion with a B, people who are either followers of Islam, followers of Judaism, followers of some other false religion, or followers of no religion. Some who even claim to be Christians, and yet who are not by the clear teachings of their religion. All of these are following false gods. And by this, Satan claims more and more souls for hell. So, my friends, it is our call. Our calling as Christians who have been given the truth to dispel these lies by proclaiming the truth of the Trinity. The truth of creation by the Father, redemption by the Son, sanctification by the Holy Spirit. We must, as we do this, follow our Lord's directions when he tells you and me to be as shrewd as snakes, but as innocent as doves. We need to be shrewd. We need to learn what these falsehoods are that people believe in, all these false notions about God, so that we can be as innocent as doves and then speak the truth intelligently from God's word, so we can counter these falsehoods with the truth of God. We follow our Lord's direction given to us through St. Peter when he says, first of all, in your own hearts, set aside Jesus Christ as Lord. Jesus must be first and foremost in your heart and your life in everything. And then, always be prepared. Always be prepared to give an answer to everyone who asks you, to give a reason for the hope that you have. But to do this, as the Bible says, with gentleness and with respect. You see, we're not trying to beat people over the head with the fact that we're right and we're wrong. No, we're worried that they have these false notions of God, because we know, like I heard someone say to me this morning, that we have a stairway to heaven, but a highway to hell. And there's a lot of people on it. We've got to get them onto that stairway by giving them the truth of God. My friends, there is in truth only 2 religions. There is Trinitarian Christianity, and there is everything else. Trinitarian Christianity leads to salvation, while all others lead to confusion and damnation. The faith that we have been given as Christians, the faith that we confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, and the Trinity that Jesus Christ has revealed to us, we believe this truth, that on our own we are lost in sin. We believe that Jesus Christ came to pay the price that we could not ever pay, and that Jesus Christ has given to us salvation as a free gift by God's grace. Not based on anything we can do, not anything that we want to do. The truth that we profess is that the Trinity is what God has done for us, not what we do for God or for our own salvation. I mean, look at any other religion, and they all boil down to the same thing. People trying to work out their own salvation. Look at Islam. There are 5 pillars in the Islamic religion. Recitation of their creed, ritual prayer, almsgiving, fasting, and pilgrimage. Did you notice that? All of those are works of men. None of them have atonement or grace or mercy. And sadly, modern Jews, from which Christians we come, they have changed the law of God from a blessing to a curse. Instead of the law pointing them to their need of a Savior, knowing that they can they try to make the law their savior by doing it just right. And sadly, there's a lot of Christians who believe that exact same thing. They base their hope of salvation not on Christ, but on their own actions. And they're in danger, too. Because when we start to believe that we are saved, or that we receive God's grace, only if we believe enough, or if we pray enough, or if we work enough, or pay enough, then we have rejected the free gift of God. And you will never work enough, or pray enough, or do enough. After all, what could be more than the death of the Son of God? How could we ever think we could actually do anything more than that? In the Athanasian Creed that we just said a few moments ago, that we all confess together, it said this, and we all said these words together. This is the Catholic faith, which except a man believe faithfully and firmly, he cannot be saved. Those words are what we said after we had confessed the truth from Scripture of who God is, the Trinity. And they are pretty strong words to say. There are some who do not believe they are true, Bernie, but they are true. If you do not believe in the Father, you do not believe in God at all. If you do not believe in the Son, you do not believe in the one who has died to pay for your sins and risen again to give you eternal life, you have no salvation because you don't believe in the source of salvation. And if you do not believe in the Holy Spirit, then you resist the one who gives you faith in Jesus Christ, to believe in the Son and the one who comes and gives you faith and strengthens you faith day after day after day. By the grace of God, you have been given, led to believe the truth. You know who God is. You might not understand it, but you know it. And He is Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, three persons, one God. And like we heard in our text this morning, this work of the Trinity to bring to you this saving faith began at your baptism. Your baptism into the name of the Triune God. The Triune God was there at the moment of your baptism. The Father was there present. And it is as if He said to you that day, "You are my child. I am your Father. I will care for you. I will provide for you. I will guarantee for you that all things, good or bad, in your life, they will all work for your good. And I will give you the ability to love me and to remain true to me." And God the Son, He was also present at your baptism. And it is as if He said to you that day, "You were lost forever. But in this water, my blood comes and it washes you clean of all of your sins. Believe in me," He says, "as the Spirit of God leads you. Believe that I am the Father's only begotten Son. I am your Savior from sin. And you shall never perish because of me, but you will have eternal life." And the Holy Spirit was present at your baptism. And it is as if He said to you, "I have given you the ability, I have given you the willingness to believe in Jesus Christ as your Savior. I have given you now the desire to live a God-pleasing life. You were dead in your sin, but I, the Lord of life, breathe life into you when you were washed, when you were sanctified into our holy Triune name." My friends, this side of eternity, because of our sin-cursed minds and because of our time and space-limited existence, we will never be able to comprehend the Triune God. But we have been given faith in Him, and that is so much better And that's all that we need. So what do we know given to us by faith? Well, what we do know gives us comfort and it gives us hope. Father, Son, and Holy Spirit are one God, unified in one work, saving you, saving me, saving all people, saving the whole world. It is the will of the Father from all of eternity that he desires all people to be saved and come to the knowledge of the truth. And that truth is that there is one mediator between God and man, the man Jesus Christ, who gave himself as a ransom for all. And all this has been made ours through the Holy Spirit's chosen means of word and sacrament by which we were called, gathered, enlightened, and sanctified into the one true faith as we await for our Lord's return to take us home into the eternal, blissful presence of our triune God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. I can't explain it, but it's true. And we believe. And so, now by the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, may the love of God, our Heavenly Father, and may the communion of the Holy Spirit, three divine persons, yet one God, be with you, remain with you in time and in eternity. And to that we say in thanks.
Amen.
Please rise.